Hello, church. This past Sunday, I talked to you about stress. We're in a month-long series called You Asked For It. You asked for some of these topics to be discussed on a Sunday morning, one of which is stress. The title of the message was Help Me, I'm Stressed. So just a real quick recap. First and foremost, we all have stress. I could list a mile long of things that stress you out, things that stress me out, that just are difficult situations. But here's the deal. Here's what I want you to get. The Bible is clear. Jesus himself is clear that this should not surprise us. In John 16:33, he says, in this world, you will have stress. There's no surprise. We're going to have things that frustrate us. The good news is this. He said, take heart. I've overcome the world. In the middle of that storm, in the middle of feeling like the weight of the world is on your shoulders, he said, I can give you peace. We have to turn to him for that peace. So we shouldn't be surprised when that stress comes. So when it comes, what does it look like? What does it do? We know that there are physical things that it does to our body. We realize that through strokes, through high blood pressure, different things. But the other things that happen is, one, our resistance is low. Your resistance to sin is low. You fall into things maybe that you normally wouldn't hadn't you been under this amount of stress. The other thing is our emotions are inconsistent. We see that in Job. Job talks about, it feels like the days are running by like faster than a sprinter or a runner, and my joy is kind of sucked out of it. So in situations where you may be joyful or happy, you find yourself very frustrated, very angry. Your spouse may even recognize it. Your kids are like, you're short-tempered. What's going on? That's stress. That's what's happening to you under stress. Another thing is our productivity suffers. Our productivity suffers. Proverbs 21:5, I want to read this to you in the Message translation. It says, careful planning puts you ahead in the long run. Hurry and scurry puts you further behind. Do you ever feel like you're hurrying and scurrying? It puts you further behind. But when you take a moment to breathe and to plan, maybe to write a list and to get things accomplished, your stress level lowers. But your productivity can suffer under stress. The other thing, and one of the most important things that we often see happen, is our relationship with God seems distant. Because we're so busy. We feel like we're being pulled in a million directions, and oftentimes the things we need the most, they're the first to go. Things that we need, obviously our relationship with Christ, we need the most, but we fail to take time for him. Psalm 46:10 says this, be still and know that I am God. Be still and relax. Take time to listen to him. Take time to get alone with him. But these are things that happens when we stress. So what do we do about it? What can we do about the stress? We know that Jesus talks about anxiety and stress. We can read that throughout scripture of kind of how to deal with that, you know, in prayer and petition. We need to go to the Lord with these things. But one thing that we see throughout the Old Testament and the New Testament, from Genesis to Revelation, we see that God encourages us to rest. We see that in Exodus chapter 20, verse 8. You can read it, the Ten Commandments, one of which, honor the Sabbath. Keep the Sabbath day holy. Understand you need a day of rest that God created in 6 days. And on that seventh day, he said rest, and he encourages us to rest. So if you want to be de-stressed, if you want to lower the amount of stress in your life, remember, it's not all going to go away. Because Jesus was clear, you're going to have trouble, anxiety. There are going to be things that come up. But if you allow yourself to rest, you kind of rest on the front and allow that rest to build up. When that stressful thing happens, you're going to have something to turn to in Christ because you've built that foundation on rest. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 9 through 11, it talks about rest as well. It talks about God's people resting. So what does that look like? Well, very simply, one thing that we need to do is rest our body. Again, in Exodus, it simply says rest. Don't work. Don't create. So rest our body. Psalm 127:2 says, in vain you rise early and you stay up late. In vain you do these things because, again, it's the hurry and scurry mode. You're not getting enough rest. You're not as sharp as you could be. You know, an illustration could simply be, have you ever tried to cut something with a dull knife or a dull blade? Guys, have you ever used a chainsaw, or maybe women too, you know, cutting down a tree and that chain gets dull because you've tried roots or dirt or rock or something. If you take the time to change that blade, allow that blade to rest, get the rested sharp blade, it's going to cut a lot quicker and you're going to be more efficient. Just like our bodies, they need time to rest. So we're not dull. We can be sharp. Rest your body. The second thing is replenish your soul. replenish your soul. Allow times, quiet times. Just get away with the Lord. You know, Psalms 23, where it talks about being next to the still waters and the green pastures. He makes me lay down and rest. You see, it's not happening next to the waterfall when life is crazy. It's when we get away and we find time, quiet time, to rest and to focus on the Lord. The other thing to replenish our soul is enjoyment. Do something you enjoy. Proverbs says, a merry heart doeth good like a medicine. You want medicine for your stress? Do things you enjoy. Have a good time. Take time on that Sabbath to have a time of quietness, to rest your body, to do things you enjoy, and to be around people. Hebrews 10:25, it talks about don't give up meeting as some of you have. That doesn't please God. Don't stop meeting with those that believe the same you do, that have the same faith, and that can encourage you in the Word and in the Lord. So we rest our body, we replenish our soul. Third and last thing says, I will refocus my spirit. You know, it's interesting as we read about Jesus, the moments before the cross, the moments before his death, the worst time in his life and in anybody's life. It said he did as usual, and he went to the Mount of Olives and he prayed. And he invited his disciples to come. What happened to them? They rested. They were taking the Sabbath thing serious and rested, but he's like, nah, not now. Let's pray. He remained focused in the most stressful time of his life. Bible says he sweat what was like blood droplets of sweat. There was stress in his life, but he remained focused on the Lord. And we need to refocus, because we leak, things leak out of us, and we need our tank filled back up with the power of Christ in our lives in order to deal with that stress. So church, as I close, let me encourage you with Psalm chapter 62, verse 1 through 8. I challenge you to write this down. When you're stressed, read it. Maybe this whole week, let that be the passage that you go to. Psalm chapter 62, verse 1 through 8 says, my soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from him. He alone is my rock, my salvation. He is my fortress. I will never be shaken. The writer of this psalm, which most think is David, talking about David, he gets it. He understands where his rest comes from, who his fortress is, who his savior is, who his rock is. And then we see, interesting, in verse 3, it says, how long will you assault a man? Would all of you throw him down? This leaning wall, this tottering fence, it feels like things are kind of caving in around him. Things are the walls are kind of closing. He's stressful. They fully intend to topple him from his lofty place. They want to take him out. They take delight in lies. With their mouths they bless, but in their hearts they curse. They say one thing but believe the other. People are against him. But then what does he say in verse 5? Find rest, O my soul, in God alone. My hope comes from him. He alone is my rock and my salvation. He is refocused. Who's his rock? Who's his fortress? It's God. He is my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in him at all times. Pour out your hearts to him, for God is our refuge. Church, I encourage you, take the Sabbath seriously. Work hard. There's no doubt about it. 6 days of work and then rest. Work hard, but don't miss the importance of rest. And when you rest, refocus yourself on the Lord. And my challenge to you, my question is, are you honoring the Sabbath? If not, what can you do this week to honor the Sabbath and even implement these things in your daily life as far as getting enough rest, replenishing your soul, refocusing your spirit on the Lord and your mind on the Lord and things of him to build you up and to allow him to be your fortress. Church, have a great week and get some rest.